Okay, so where do I start with this one? Seriously, folks, I'm going to have to rein myself in a bit. Because for about 10 years, from the mid-70s on, it felt like Kristy McNichol was everywhere. But since this video is a Whatever Happened To video, I'm only going to mention a handful of my favorite memories before I provide an update regarding what she's been up to more recently. Otherwise, this thing could last hours. I still remember this Dynamite magazine, and even though it says Meet Kristy McNichol, I'm pretty sure I already knew who she was. Even before she became a breakout star on the TV show Family, more on that in a moment, she had been in commercials and guest starred on a number of shows like Starsky and Hutch and The Bionic Woman. However, like I said, it was on Family where Kristy really became a breakout star. She was the youngest member of the Lawrence family, a tomboy nicknamed Buddy. And I don't know, maybe it's just my old foggy memory, but it seemed like many, many of the shows during its 5-season run centered on Buddy. A couple of other things worth mentioning are that, yes, that's a pre-Family Ties Meredith Baxter Burney there, and the actor who played the father on this show is James Broderick. Yep, that's right, father of Ferris. And here she is, cute as a button with Scott Baio, guest starring on The Love Boat. Seriously, folks, back then, being on The Love Boat was a rite of passage for every up-and-coming young star, as well as many of the really big stars from Hollywood's golden age. And I've also got to mention Little Darlings. If I remember correctly, this was Kristy's first big starring role in a major motion picture. I haven't seen this movie in years. I kind of wonder if it holds up. Still, the cast is great. Along with Kristy, you've got Tatum O'Neill, Armand Assante, and a very young Matt Dillon. And even though it was a major flop, I've got to, at least for a moment, talk about the pirate movie. Sure, there are a lot of things that you can nitpick about this film, but the soundtrack is incredible, and it was here that it dawned on me that Kristy really had a wonderful voice, and it was clear that she loved singing. Why this is so surprising, I do not know. Because prior to this movie, Kristy had released an album with her brother Jimmy and done some singing in the movie The Night the Lights Went Out in Georgia. Somewhere after the pirate movie and before Just the Way You Are, I remember hearing about difficulties that the studio was having getting that movie completed. I also vaguely recall hearing that there were issues with getting Kristy on the set. Still, when the movie was released in 1984, I remember seeing it in the theater with a group of friends, and we all agreed that Ms. McNichol was the very best part of the movie. And then you know what? She kind of disappeared for a few years. Rumor has it that she just wanted to live a normal life and went back to school to learn how to cut and style hair. And then in 1988, Kristy resurfaced on Empty Nest, an NBC situation comedy which was a spin-off from one of my favorite shows, The Golden Girls. This TV series was a ton of fun, mainly because of the standout cast. Isn't that always the case? Which included Richard Mulligan, Dinah Manoff, and David Leisure. A year later, Kristy bared her soul to People magazine and talked about her bipolar disorder and the severe depression that is brought about by a chemical imbalance in her body. Tough stuff, and Kristy had been dealing with it for years. At the time the article was written, Kristy had been working as an in-demand actress for over 20 years, and yet she was just 27. You know, when I think about other child actors that rode a similar wave of fame during the 70s and 80s, not many of them ended up in as good of a place as Kristy, and that's even with the health issues that she was so bravely fighting. In 1992, Kristy made the tough decision to leave Empty Nest, and when she returned for the series finale in 1995, that final bow she took on stage with the rest of her castmates, well, it really was a final bow. So what has she been doing since then? Well, the answer is really a whole heck of a lot. During the 90s, Kristy hosted her own tennis tournament, which benefited the Help Group, a charity that serves children with special needs related to autism, learning disabilities, ADHD, developmental delays, abuse, and other emotional problems. Kristy has also volunteered time assisting with marine wildlife conservation groups. From what I understand, she has even participated in rescues from time to time. End of the day, for a very long time, it seems to me that Kristy had wanted one thing. Really, the one thing that fame and fortune in Hollywood couldn't give her. A normal life. Years earlier, when she'd gone to school to learn how to become a hairstylist, I think she knew that she was going to have to take really drastic action if she ever wanted any sort of normalcy in her life. And for that reason, in June of 2001, Kristy announced through her publicist that she was officially retiring from acting. Now, to be clear, that retirement has been her way of saying that she wasn't going to be in front of the cameras anymore. It didn't mean that she didn't love the art and craft of acting. In fact, I've heard that Kristy has spent some of her free time with up-and-coming actors, helping them to hone their talents. And in 2012, Kristy came out of the closet and expressed a desire to be more open, honest, and authentic about the person that she truly was. At the time, she also said that she was coming out to try and help other kids who might be bullied because of who they were. I have just got to say, what a truly noble thing to do. And even more recently, Kristy lent her support to the Los Angeles Valley College's music department and encouraged other lovers of music to do the same through the school's foundation, which provides student scholarships and supports various campus music programs. That type of support shouldn't come as a surprise to any of us who watched her sing her heart out decades earlier. In fact, Kristy became familiar with the school's music department because she wanted an outlet for her passion for singing and enrolled in a class where she could participate in the college's choir. How cool is that? So, this Whatever Happened To video has my favorite kind of ending. The kind where I get to say that whoever is being spotlighted has managed to avoid most, if not all, of the pitfalls that far too frequently do folks in when it comes to the world of showbiz. Kristy truly is living her best life. I'm sure it still has trials. I'm sure it still has its fair share of ups and downs. But you know what? It's a normal life. And that, when it comes right down to it, is a pretty darn good. If you're trying to find Kristy out there on Twitter or Facebook, well, you're not going to have a whole heck of a lot of luck. But you know what? I think that's all right. I think that's part of her effort, her attempt to just step away from it all and live that normal life that I've talked about. All right, I can't help myself. We're going back to the pirate movie. If you want to watch that movie and hear Kristy sing, the whole thing right now is on YouTube. At some point, they're probably going to take it down, but my guess is that there will always be somewhere online where you can watch this often maligned musical gem. So, do you remember Kristy McNichol? And if so, what was your favorite movie or TV show that she was in? Let me know in the comments section, and if you liked this video, I'd love a thumbs up. I'd also be honored if you would consider subscribing to my channel. I talk about music, movies, and television, mostly from the 50s, 60s, 70s, and 80s. You know, the good stuff. But most importantly, and as always, thank you so much for watching.